Alright, I was recording a video, continuing chapter 6, and I realized a very large portion of this chapter is incredibly boring. So I'm going to sort of skim through the pages and touch on the notable things on them. So we left off with Roger being very proud that he was making good maid. So, after that, Mrs. Mantle shows up. They sit down for tea, and Roger spills something on her skirt. She takes off her skirt and then whips Roger with a riding crop. Still getting the riding crop. And still getting the fucking riding crop. Oh my god. Okay. And her petticoat got dirty. And there's a very long monologue about girls masturbating, and it pauses because as Mrs. Mantle is openly frotting herself, she notices that Roger's panties look familiar, which is questionable. So she brings it up and then she just continues masturbating and talking about masturbating. And then she gets Roger involved, he eats her out. They have a conversation. More conversation. Okay. Then, you know, after his encounter with Mrs. Mantle, it jumps to one evening a few days later. Dido came in to his room as he was sleeping naked, and she has a nurse's bag with her, which we have seen before, which actually was in a chapter I didn't record. I'll have to go back and do that one of these days. And, she fucks him, blah blah blah. That actually goes on for a while. Okay. So after that, they have sex, and then Dido is somehow still full of energy and ready to commit the next depraved act in her repertoire. She drew from her bag a long, shining hygienic appliance. Uh-oh. "This, Roger," Dido said, "is known as a dildo." Dido's got a dildo. Who could have seen that coming? I peered closely. It was a device of two black rubber cylinders or prongs shaped like males' cocks, and strikingly similar in dimension and shape to my own. She ordered me to turn on my belly and spread the cheeks of my bum so that she could see my pucker. I did so, trembling in genuine alarm. "You mean to poke me in the bum hole, mistress?" "Yes, but I've never..." "Then it will be all the more painful and humiliating, Roger," she whispered. "You do want to wear your pretty new dress and knickers and everything for me, don't you?" She stroked the massive rubber shafts of the dildo and smiled. Then she unfastened her skirt completely and laid it aside, her arse globes gleaming as I watched. I turned my head in horrified fascination as she took one of the prongs and parted her quim lips, played at the wet channel of her gash and at her nubbin with little sighs of contentment, then firmly thrust the black shaft all the way into her slit with a sigh of greater contentment. She strapped the device by a cord around her waist so that the second prong stood up from her gash like a giant penis. We've got a double-ended dildo over here, Jared. It's like a strap-on and a double-ended dildo.
More the better.
Yeah, the more the better. Framed prettily by her garters and stocking tops and the bare flesh beneath, she had her shoes on and playfully lifted her agile leg to poke one heel inside my spread bum hole. It hurt terribly. I groaned, and she laughed rather scornfully, saying a mere lady's heel was nothing at all. She wriggled the heel very deep and painfully inside my anus, and despite my squirming and discomfort, I felt my cock stiffen hard. It does not take much for this guy. Then she scissored her thighs and brought up her other leg, and to my horror, I felt her second pointed heel join the first, squeezing beside it deep into my anus, so that my bum skin was stretched tight as a drum. Again, another logistical issue. I don't know how that just happened. She scissored and both feet? I don't know. Anyway, both of her heels are in his anus now. That's the important thing. Vigorously, she poked my bumhole with both heels. I howled in anguish, but my penis throbbed and my balls ached with welling sperm as though my erection was about to burst me. Dido bum-heeled me most severely until I was squirming in delicious pain, and she said that it was the foretaste of a proper bumming. She put her fingers to her quim and soaked them in her love juice, with which she oiled the shaft that was to penetrate my person. To be penetrated, and by a lady. Such a fierce yet thrilling word. I whimpered to her that my bum had never been poked before. There was a slithering plop as she removed her heel from the elastic clutch of my bum hole. Protest all you want, she said lazily. It shan't do you any good. I gasped and yelped as I felt the huge cold tip of the dildo burst into the tender opening of my bumhole. She laughed more and said that was only an inch. You know, this is supposed to be taking place in England, and that's not a metric measurement. It would be centimeters. I don't know how many centimeters. Oh, the British. Then she pushed very hard. The dildo slid into my groaning shaft, and the pain was indescribable. Oh, it's worse than the birch, I moaned. The prong seemed stuck. She ordered me to relax my bum muscle, which I did as best I could, but her thrusts only seemed to increase my bumhole's resistance to the invader. I moaned that it was no good, and she wouldn't fit. I thought of the horrid shaft as hers. But she snapped that I had buggered grub to the hilt, and my anus could take it too. Alright, I think that's a good stopping point, a good cliffhanger for the next video.